Now, I request for the keynote address by Honorable Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare, Shri J.P. Nadda garu.
Dr. Lakshman Reddy, the Honorable Minister for Health and Medical Education and Health and Family Welfare, Government of Telangana, Shri C.K. Mishraji, Additional Secretary and Mission Director, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Shri Mahendra Reddy Ji, the Minister for Transport, Government of Telangana, Shri Narsaya Gaur Ji, my colleague in the Lok Sabha, my esteemed colleague in the Lok Sabha and Member Parliament, Shri Prakash Gaur Ji, the MLA, Honorable MLA from this particular area, Shri Rakesh Kumar, Joint Secretary, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Shri Rajeshwar Tiwari Ji, the Principal Secretary, Government of Telangana, Department of Health and Family Welfare, Dr. Budh Prakash, Commissioner and Health, Medical and Family Welfare, Dr. Amar Pali, Joint Collector and District Magistrate, Rangareddy District, Dr. Praveen Kumar, IPS, Secretary, Social Welfare, Residential Schools, whose work has been very much appreciated, Srimati Prashanti, Joint Secretary, Women and Child Welfare, Development Partners, WHO, and Deworm the World, distinguished members on the dais and distinguished gentry here, ladies and gentlemen, dear students, and members representing the press. It is indeed a matter of great happiness for me to be here this afternoon on the launch of the Deworming Day, the National Deworming Day, which is going to be implemented tomorrow on 10th of February. And it has been launched today. This program will be conducted in all the states and union territories. And on the 15th of February, it will be a mop-up program where the left-outs will be also taken care of. At the outset, I would like to thank the Government of Telangana for hosting this launch ceremony program. I'd also like to thank the Department of Sanitation, Women and Child Welfare, the Panchayati Raj, for participating in this program and collectively trying to see to it that India, the young India, is healthy India, and the children who survive also and thrive also. Keeping that factor in view, whatever interventions are needed, all those interventions are to be undertaken. We all know that approximately the cohort of children in the country is 2.6 crore and more than 27 crore children are to be taken under this program of deworming. We have selected the school here because primarily out of the 27 crore children, 19 crore children are studying in schools, and that is why we have considered to take school education on board to see to it that our deworming program is a successful program. We have undergone a long way to work out the nitty-gritties, and minute details have been worked out to see that this is a successful program. Last year, we launched this program in Rajasthan. Not all the states were included, and the target was 8 crore children. We were successful. The target was 11 crore children, and we were successfully able to deworm 8 crore children. And this year, the target is 27 crore. We have upscaled, and all the states and all the union territories have been undertaken. Friends, the health department has gone a long way to see to it that reproductive child health care, where we take the care of the mother, the children, and make them healthier, many interventions have taken place. All these interventions have helped us in reducing the MMR, the maternal mortality ratio, which is now 167 per lakh live births, and the under 5 mortality to 49 of per 1,000 live births. We are now very close to MDGs. The Millennium Development Goals, we have been very close to it. And the SDGs, the Sustainable Development Goal, I assure you that my ministry will work very hard to see that we are successful in SDGs and we bring it India into the right ambit and see to it that India is healthier, stronger, especially for the young Indians. If we look back the picture, in 1990, India's under 5 mortality stood at 126, while the global average at that point of time was 90. But in 2013, because of many interventions which we have undertaken, the figure has dropped down to 49 against the global average of 46. Now you can see that we from 126 has reached 49, and the global average from 90 has only reached 46. So we are only 3 less. We started from 126 and we are 49. They started from 90 and it is only 43. So if we see the pace, India has been faster than the world or the global rate of the MMR and the IMR, which is a very significant figure which we have to see to it. We all also know that on 27th of March 2014, India was declared as a polio-free country. Along with the other Southeast Asian regions, India was declared polio-free. It was done because of all the stakeholders who had worked day in and day out very hard. And after a very focused program, we were successful in that. But now, we plan to go beyond polio. And for that, you will be happy to know that last year, India has been certified by WHO in maternal and neonatal tetanus elimination program. Now India is in maternal and neonatal tetanus program. It has been eliminated in India, which has been certified by WHO. And we have been able to successfully do it before the global targets was given. Before that, we had completed our target and we got the certification. As you all know, that a newborn child is given 7 types of vaccination. This year, we have added 4 more. So the basket is now increased of vaccination for the children from 7 to 11. We have introduced rotavirus. We know that approximately 3 to 4 lakh children used to die every year because of rotavirus. So rotavirus has been included. IPV has been included. So the OPV will also continue and IPV will be also introduced. The measles rubella has been introduced. The adult JE has been introduced. And pneumococcal is also being introduced. So we are trying to increase the basket of vaccination and make the children much healthier, much stronger, not only survive, but thrive and come out as a healthier children. That is what we are trying to do. We have made special programs. In coming times, we'll be able to eliminate Kalazar. In coming times, we'll be addressing the lymphatic filariasis, and we'll be able to get rid of leprosy. So we'll be also eradicating leprosy. These are our targets which we are going to take care in coming times. We have taken number of intervention, we have introduced number of programs and interventions which has brought all these results. We have also increased our facility-based care. We have encouraged institutional deliveries. We have developed a life cycle approach, RMNCHA, reproductive, maternal, child health care, and adolescent. We take care of the mother right from the moment she gets pregnant. From that very time, we start giving her iron and folic acid supplementation. We give her all types of necessary interventions which are needed. After the child is born, first of all, we see to it that the child is born in institutional delivery. We give the transport facility so that the mother comes to the facility. The facilities are given free of cost, drug and diagnostic and all facilities. If complication takes place, that is also taken care. And after that, we also see to it that the mother goes safe home. So that transport facility is also given. Not only that, we see after 11 types of vaccination, iron and folic acid supplementation weekly is given to the child till he reaches the age of adolescent. So it's a life cycle approach which we have developed. From mother to child and child to again becoming a mother, we have taken an approach, we are trying to do it. So keeping this factor in view, newborn care corners have been established throughout the country, 16,968. 2,228 newborn stabilization units have been developed. 602 newborn care units have been made operational. And you'll be happy to know, I would like to share, that 90% of the survival rates are there because of essence use which we have developed. And the children are able to survive now 90% because of these interventions. We have started the program of Mission Indradhanush. We all know that every year we have a cohort of 2 crore 60 lakh children who have to be immunized. But we also knew that approximately 61% of immunization was taking place. So every year, approximately 90 lakh children were left out. And these 90 lakh children, 72 lakh children were partially immunized. And 18 lakh children were fully unimmunized. So we took the program of Mission Indradhanush. And in this Mission Indradhanush, we tried to focus on those left outs. You'll happy to know that we have been able to fully immunize in 1 year 35 lakh new children. And 8 lakh new children have been identified. We were beyond reach, have been brought into the reach. So our immunization now, which was increasing by a rate of 1% per year, has somewhere reached now, which will be authenticated later. But the figures say, because when 35 lakh children have been immunized totally, so the figure is reaching somewhere 7 to 8%. This is what the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, with all your cooperation, has been able to do it. India Newborn Action Plan is also brought into action, where we want to bring an environment so that the child is healthy. We want to give the environment where sanitation is, facilities are there. We are trying to give them an environment where nutrition aspects are also addressed and health issues are also addressed. For this only, Rashtriya Bal Swasth Karyakram has been undertaken, in which we have taken care of 4 D's. Diseases of childhood, deficiencies, development delays, including disabilities. Which the minister Lakshmanji was talking about the Telangana. This is how the program which has been specifically taken in Telangana, when the child is born, if he is with some deficiencies or some problems, symptoms are there, it is treated at the earliest. The same way we are trying to see to it that in childhood the deficiencies are addressed, the development delays are addressed, and the disabilities are addressed. So for this only, approximately 6.55 crores children have been screened. More than 20 lakh children have been referred to health facilities, and 13 lakh children have availed the facilities of secondary and tertiary health care. That means out of 6.5 crore children, 13 lakh children were screened and found out, and they were addressed also, and they were given their relief, whatever was needed. This is how we are trying to go forward. Today, when we are launching, this is also a very important aspect, because if the child is anemic, if the child is deficient, if the child is not healthy, and we get it because of the soil transmitted helminths, and for that we have to administer albendazole, the medicine, the tablet which can give relief. We all know that because of the worm load, the environment of contamination, the risk of infection is there, and approximately 2 crore children, that is 68%, are infested with this problem. 2 crore children. That is the statistics show. So it impairs the physical growth of the children. It is a deficiency of anemia, and the performances of the children also reduces in the school. Absentees are there. Students get absent. They do not want to study. They are not able to give good results. So keeping that factor in view, this deworming program has been taken. I would request all the health activists, all the health leaders who are sitting in front of me, to participate and see to it that we make this program a success. If we are able to hit the target of 27 crores, India will be a healthier, and we will have healthy India, healthy young India, which we try to aspire. I would also like to see to it that the young children participate. They not only participate, but act as a peer among the friends, among the brethren, to see to it that they make it a movement. It is a focused program where we are going to do it on one day, and on 15th of February, we will be doing the mop-up so that any absentee is not left out. It's a program which needs support of all of you, and I not only hope, I am fully confident that everybody is going to cooperate in this program and make this program a successful program. You see, whatever we introduce in India, it is globally the largest program because of the size of the country, because of the size of the population. I always say, don't compare India. India is incomparable. We can't compare with any country. It's a huge country. It's a country where 1.2 billion people. When I on international forums, when I say that I'm here to wish you on behalf of 1.2 million people, 2.5 million people, people get aghast by just hearing the number. And that too, starting from far-flung areas of Leh, Ladakh, Lahol Spiti, the desert mountains, to the Bastar area, tribal areas, developing a cold chain and giving them facilities to those far-flung areas, going to the distant areas, and then giving a program. So this program is also a deworming program, which is world's largest public health program, which we have to understand. And we have to make it successful. With all your good wishes, we'll make it successful. That is what I am confident. I would also like to assure on this forum to my colleague, esteemed colleague, who has raised the issues related to AIIMS. The Government of India has decided that phase-wise we'll be having AIIMS, and Telangana is on priority list. That is what I can assure. The same way, he has also talked about the ASHA workers. No doubt ASHA workers are the backbone of our all national programs. We salute them, we respect them, and we empower them. We will see to it that how we can make them best and how we can make their services best. With your cooperation, we'll do the needful. That is what I can assure you. In the end, once again, I thank you all for giving me a very patient hearing, and with your cooperation, and especially with the cooperation of the students, we will find a healthy India, a healthy young India. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. One of the world's biggest public health campaign is being launched by Honorable Health Minister Government of India, Shri Jagat Prakash Nadda ji. Aapka bhashan sunke har child Prakash ki gati se aur tez se aage badhega. Thanks for that, sir. Now I request Honorable Central Minister, Honorable State Minister on the dais to give medicines to the students. కాంతిగారు ఇప్పుడు ఆ విద్యార్థులను వేదికపైకి ఆహ్వానిస్తారు.